This video will show a typical installation of the gravity cavity rainscreen drainage plane with a thin stone veneer. The gravity cavity creates a continuous rainscreen drainage plane behind the thin veneer and is vented to the top and bottom of the wall system. Fasten and space sheathing as required by code. For the bottom termination, we'll be using the L&R weep screed. The literature for most weep screeds clearly states that they do not weep. The L&R weep screed is the only weep screed designed to weep and ventilate rainscreen wall systems. The weep screed is installed at or below the foundation plate line, fastened to the framing and or foundation. Apply the code required weather-resistive barrier over the sheathing per manufacturer's instructions. The weather-resistive barrier should lap the attachment flange of the L&R weep screed. Before installing the gravity cavity, create an insect screen by back wrapping the fabric and taping it in place. With the fabric facing the weather, place the gravity cavity into the L&R weep screed. Ensure the gravity cavity is slid all the way to the bottom of the L&R weep screed trough. Lightly tack the gravity cavity in place every 2 feet on center. It will be permanently held in this position by the thin veneer. Roll out and tack the next course of gravity cavity. The fabric skirt laps in shingle fashion, but the corrugated plastic should be butted. It is not necessary to align the channels. For the top of the wall, field fabricate the gravity cavity to fit the remaining space. Score it with a utility knife and crack off the excess material, leaving the fabric. Lap the excess fabric over the top edge of the gravity cavity and tape it in place to create an insect screen. Position the gravity cavity so there is a small ventilation gap between the gravity cavity and the soffit, and then fasten it in place. Fasten the metal termination to the framing, using a spacer to maintain a minimum 3/8 inch gap for ventilation between the termination and the soffit. This 3/8 inch gap ensures proper ventilation behind the veneer. Next, install the metal lath. Place the bottom edge of the first course of lath in the bottom of the trough of the L&R weep screed, and fasten according to code. Expanded metal lath sheets are installed in shingle fashion, with each course overlapping the previous course by 3 inches. The top course of metal lath is placed into the channel of the top metal termination. Press the scratch coat mortar to completely envelop the metal lath. Fill the L&R weep screed and metal termination. A spacer can be used to keep the ventilation gap free from mortar. Strike the mortar smooth, and then scratch the mortar to create grooves to aid in attaching the thin veneer. When the L&R weep screed is filled with mortar, the drainage slots stay open, promoting clear drainage and ventilation from the gravity cavity. Before applying the thin veneer, use a spacer to prevent trash mortar from filling the gap between the soffit and the metal termination. Butter the back of the thin veneer to apply to the scratch coat. Be sure there is enough mortar to attach properly to the scratch coat. Apply the thin veneer, starting at the top of the wall to prevent trash mortar from falling on already applied stone. When applying thin veneer, pay special attention that the holes of the L&R weep screed do not become plugged with excess mortar. After applying the stone at the top of the wall, remove the spacer and verify that the ventilation gap is clear of trash mortar. Attach a soffit trim board in front of the stone, leaving a small gap for ventilation. The trim board provides increased protection from weather and a finished appearance. To keep building better with MTI, subscribe to our channel and like this video. For additional information, visit us at mtidry.com or call 800-879-3348.